Good afternoon, everyone. Christ Church Cathedral acknowledges that it carries out its mission and ministry on the ancestral territories of the Songhees and the Squamault First Nations, the Lekwungen-speaking peoples. And I think it's particularly important to make that acknowledgement on this national holiday weekend and to acknowledge the wrong that we have committed as the Anglican Church of Canada, not least through the residential school system. My name is Donald Hunt, and I'm the Director of Music here at Christ Church Cathedral, where today we kick off our summer recital series. This chamber music series is celebrating its 60th season, and we're just so pleased to see so many of you here today. Wherever you are from, please know that you are welcome in this place. Historically, cathedrals are common ground, so please make yourselves comfortable while you're with us for the next hour or so. This is your building. Thank you for your donations on the way in. We don't receive any government support for these concerts, so your generosity is what makes this possible. And to be blunt, your generosity on the way in or on the way out will be what ensures that our performer receives a fair fee. And if you're watching us online, you can make your gift by clicking the link in the video's description. And just to say that Sarah Hagen has a fringe show, that's a comedy show where she talks about all the dodgy performance venues that she's done. So please, let's make sure that she's happy with us today. Next week's recital is given by the choir of St. Mary's Church, Nottingham, in the UK. They perform a program of English sacred music from the Renaissance to the present day. Turning now to today's performance, hailed as something to absolutely die for, Sarah Hagen's 2021 recording of Bach's Goldberg Variations won 2 PEI Music Awards, and you can purchase copies on the way out of that CD, by the way, along with some other recordings. With strong West Coast roots, now living in PEI, her performances have engaged audiences from all over the world. We're incredibly fortunate to hear her live today in concert. Please would you welcome Sarah Hagen. Thank you.
You know, Goldberg must be one of the most famous names in classical music, and yet we so rarely actually hear his music. So I began with that little nugget of his, a little prelude in C major to start us off. As the legend has it, the story of how the Goldberg variations came by their name is that a man by the name of Count Kaiserling suffered from terrible insomnia. So he hired a young virtuoso harpsichordist by the name of Johann Gottlieb Goldberg to entertain him during his sleepless nights. And apparently Johann Sebastian Bach caught wind of this. And he said, well, why don't I write something? How about I write an air with 30 variations, too many variations, a kind of musical counting sheep. And because Goldberg was the first one to play it, so it came by its name. But now scholars have realized that somebody wrote that story down in a book in around 1850, and we've just accepted it as the truth, and it probably isn't so. So if we're in the business of making up stories, I have my own theory. I think that Bach owed Goldberg money. And he went to him and he said, Johann. And Goldberg said, yes, Johann. And he said, listen, Goldberg, I have so many mouths to feed and I don't have much money. How about I name this piece after you and make you famous till the end of time? We know that Bach didn't have very much money. As all the textbooks tell us, Bach was Baroque. In April 2020, I woke up one day to find an entire season of concerts canceled. And I found myself with a great deal of time, luxury of time on my hands. And I had all these great plans for all the repertoire I was going to learn. And then in the middle of the night, a voice came to me and it said, you are going to learn the Goldberg variations. And the next morning I got up and I thought, but I don't even want to. But when a voice comes to you like that, you listen to it. And what I ended up doing, because I had this luxury of time, I didn't take the score to the piano. Instead, I listened to countless recordings, and while I was doing so, I made art. And I made a piece of art to accompany each variation. And what this showed me, which I don't think I would have realized to the same extent had I been kind of drowning in the virtuosity and the technicality of it all, this is music filled with light. You know, when you make art, you're always asking yourself about light and shadow, and this is filled with light. It's incredibly optimistic music. And people talk about the Goldberg variations, they say, oh, I love the Goldberg variations. But you should say, I love the Goldberg variations. It's such joyous music. And in fact, out of the 30 variations, only 3 are in the minor key, and this is significant. In fact, we don't even hear the minor key until almost the halfway point, variation 15. So when you feel the world crashing in on you, you'll know we're almost halfway finished. And at the end of that variation, the notes, the hands reach out to the last final notes of the keyboard, or what was the keyboard at the time. Of course, now there are more keys on the keyboard because of inflation, I guess. And then the second half begins this wonderful, joyous overture. The third time we hear the minor variation is variation 25. This is the longest variation, and I think maybe the most important. It's where Bach is taking us to. In this variation, Bach seems to wrap up all of the hopes and cares, all of the pain, and all of the joys of the whole world, and leaves them there, right for us in this variation. And then the last five variations are really a resolution of that. When we get to the last variation, variation 30, this is actually a combination of four different songs, which seems kind of masterful. And apparently the Bach family liked to sit around the kitchen table and see if they could combine different songs together and see if they fit. And we know what two of the songs are. One is more longing. It says, "You've been away so long, come near, my love." And the second song we know of is quite different. It says, "Cabbages and turnips have driven me away. Mother, if you'd only cooked meat, I'd have opted to stay." So we finish with this anti-vegetarian anthem. But what it shows us is this element of joy that is throughout. And then the aria repeats at the end. It's the same, but of course it's different, because we are different through the process of listening. This is music for our time. It's music for this painful time we're living in, music for coming out of a pandemic. It is music filled with laughter and light and love, and most important, optimism. Thanks for being here today.
Thank you.
Thought we would stay in the key of G major. The little Rachmaninoff prelude, which I would like to offer up as a prayer to Ukraine, and I don't think Rachmaninoff would mind.